By now, you know the world around you is made of molecules. And you might know also what molecules are made of. Atoms. And then we know what atoms are made of. They're made of electrons, protons, and neutrons. What are electrons, protons, and neutrons made of? Are they made of smaller particles, or is that the smallest we can go? Well, the answer is mixed. For the electron, it turns out to be a fundamental particle. There's no smaller particle that makes up the electron, as far as we know. But for protons and neutrons, there are even smaller particles called quarks. In fact, every proton and every neutron are made of three quarks. This area of physics is called particle physics, and it's extremely new. It's been developing within my lifetime. In fact, the most recent really important discovery happened in just 2012. Particle physics talks about all of the different things that make up the world around us, even when they're smaller than protons and neutrons. Let's learn about this emerging area of physics. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the particles that make up matter. Then we'll introduce the particles that mediate forces. I know that sounds a little weird, but we'll use tons of examples that'll make it really clear. Then we'll introduce the four fundamental forces that exist in the universe. Let's start by taking a look at our atom. Here we have our atom with the neutron and the proton in the center. They make up the nucleus and electrons orbiting around them. But do these subatomic particles have anything that makes them up? Are there any smaller building blocks? In the cases of protons and neutrons, the answer is yes. Here you see a proton on the left and a neutron on the right. Inside these gray circles, you have the different components that make up a proton and a neutron. Protons are made up of quarks, and so are neutrons. The U's stand for up quarks, and the D stands for down quarks, so two different types of quarks. Notice that protons have two up quarks and one down quark, while neutrons have one up quark and two down quarks. Of course, up and down means nothing to you right now, and that's totally okay. Just know that they're made up of quarks and that there's at least two different types. You should also know that quarks have charge, just like electrons and protons have charge. Their charges, though, come in two different forms, either minus 1/3 or plus 2/3. I know it might seem a little weird to have fractions of charges, but don't worry, it's totally fine. And you'll see how these give us the nice uniform plus one and minus one we're used to in just a second. A down quark has a charge of minus 1/3, while an up quark has a charge of plus 2/3. With that in mind, let's take a look at the neutron and consider the total charge. Remember that neutrons should be neutral, and it has one up quark and two down quarks. The up quark is plus 2/3, and the down quark is minus 1/3. So then we have another down quark also at minus 1/3. When we take plus 2/3, we subtract 1/3, and then another third, we get 0. So overall, the charge on the neutron is 0, even though the quarks that make it up actually do have charge. Now let's take a look at the proton. It has two up quarks and one down quark. Each up quark is plus 2/3, and the down quark is minus 1/3. So when I add 2/3 to 2/3, I get 4/3, and then I take away a third, and I just get regular old plus 1, exactly what you expect for a proton. Now, the reason we don't talk about quarks very often is because they always come together in these packages. Quarks cannot be isolated. So they basically will always be together in these packages, and you can't pull them apart. You should also know that quarks come in many flavors. Flavors is a weird word to describe the different types of quarks. Here's all the quarks that exist. We've already seen up and down, shown there on the left, but it turns out there's charm, top, strange, and bottom. So many quarks. Now, importantly, the only quarks that really make up everyday matter are up and down. Charm, top, strange, and bottom only occur under exotic circumstances, like early in the universe or in something called a particle accelerator. So up or down are really the two most important quarks, and they make up the neutron and the proton, as we've discussed. What about the electron? Are there any smaller parts that make up the electron? Does it have quarks inside it as well? The answer is no. The electron just looks like a basic building block of matter. It does come in a particular category, though, with all of its friends called leptons. Leptons come in the electron, the muon, and the tau. So those are three different leptons. And the electron, once again, is by far the most important one. Muons and taus, much like many of our quarks just don't show up that often. Electrons show up in everyday matter, and that's why they're by far the most important one. They all have a charge of minus one. Here's the thing about leptons. All leptons are made in pairs. So kind of like shoes come in pairs. Whenever there's a left shoe, you have a right shoe. That same thing occurs for leptons. When they begin to exist, they come with a pair. Their partners are called neutrinos. So if we go back to take a look at our leptons, we'll see that electrons have a pair called the electron neutrino. And the muon has a pair called the muon neutrino. And the tau has a pair called the tau neutrino. Neutrinos are very light, and the reactions which generate them release tons of energy, so they move very fast. In fact, neutrinos move at near light speed. All right, let's sum up where we've been so far. Here's all of our zoo of particles, and I know this looks like a whole lot. Just keep in mind that the up quark, the down quark, and the electron are the main things that make up matter around you, and the rest of them are things that show up under pretty strange circumstances. Quarks and leptons together have a special name. Quarks and leptons are fermions. Okay? And that's an important category to know because it differentiates them from something we'll talk about in a second. What do fermions do? Fermions build matter. So when I look at my atom, all of the matter there is made up of fermions. The other category of particles, which we'll talk about in a second, help us answer this question. How does the electron feel the proton's force? So we have our electron and it's separated from the proton, right? They're not touching each other. So how does the electron and proton know about each other? How does the electron know it should stay glued to that a proton? How does the electron feel the proton's force? It turns out the answer is something called bosons. Bosons carry forces, which again sounds pretty strange, but let me explain what that means. You can think about bosons a bit like baseballs. The force of the bat is eventually felt by the outfielder. How? It's the baseball. The baseball carries the force from one spot to another. If there was no baseball, the outfielder would never feel that force. And that's just what some bosons do. They carry force. Let's look at an example. Here we have a woman staring off at a sunset. What's going on here? Well, the high temperature of the sun causes the electrons and protons within it to shake. And those shaking charges eventually move charges in our eyes, which we detect as light. But what carries that electromagnetic force all the way from the sun to our eyes? It turns out to be the boson called a photon, which we've seen before. So the photon is a particle that carries the electromagnetic force. Many of the fundamental forces have particles like this. So let's review the four fundamental forces and then the particles that are associated with carrying the force. First up, we have the electromagnetic force, which is responsible for the interaction between charges, and then the strong nuclear force. As we saw in our last lesson, this is responsible for holding the nucleus together. We have the weak nuclear force, which is responsible for nuclear decay, and lastly, the gravitational force, which is responsible for the attraction between mass. We've already looked at the electromagnetic force, which is present here, and how it's carried by the photon. What about the strong nuclear force? Remember, this strong nuclear force glues together the nucleus by an attraction between neutrons and neutrons and neutrons and protons. Well, what's responsible for mediating this force? It's a particle called the gluon, which is pretty sweet. It sounds like glue and it glues together the nucleus, so that kind of helps. So the gluon is the boson associated with the strong nuclear force. Wow, that's a lot. There's a lot of terminology here, which can be tough to get down. Remember, you're just kind of getting a taste of particle physics. Next, we have the weak nuclear force. These radioactive barrels are giving off radiation because the atoms within them are decaying. This decay is in part due to the weak nuclear force. So, for example, when you have a nucleus give off energy and a particle, we call this radiation, and that force has to be mediated just like the others. It turns out there are two bosons here responsible for this force, the Z boson and the W boson. All right, on to the gravitational force. This is what causes the attraction between the Earth and the Moon. Here's the funny thing about the gravitational force. We haven't discovered the boson associated with it. Many physicists hypothesize that there's something called a graviton, which is the boson that might mediate the gravitational force, but it has not yet been observed. So, as far as we know, there's not a graviton yet. Which raises the question, how do we study these particles anyways? How would we look for the graviton? We study these things with particle accelerators, which you see here as this blue tube, which is bending. This can bend into an enormous ring that can be up to 16 miles long, and particles move through these tubes at speeds very near the speed of light and collide, and when they do, they create huge numbers of particles. And that's how we've discovered all of these strange things we've looked at in this video. The most recent discovery was something called the Higgs boson, which was discovered in 2012, and that gives us our complete standard model of elementary particles. Here they are, all of the particles that we know of that make up matter. As we've said, the up-down quarks and the electron are by far the most important, but you can see also that things like photons, gluons, and the other bosons are really important as well. All right, let's test your knowledge. What I want you to do is determine if each claim about particle physics is true or false. Pause the video and give this a try, and then I'll go through these one at a time. Okay, let's start with A. Protons and neutrons are made of quarks. Well, that's true. Those are the basic constituents of protons and neutrons. B, electrons are bosons. That's false. Remember that bosons are the things that carry forces, and electrons are actually leptons, which fit under the category of fermions. Is that enough fancy words for you? Wow, this is a lot. Okay, C, bosons can carry forces. As we've just mentioned, that's true. Bosons carry forces. That's the main thing that they do. D, all the fundamental forces have corresponding bosons. That's false, because remember that we don't know if there's a boson for the gravitational force. Let's review what we've learned. First, we introduced the particles that make up matter. We saw that neutrons and protons are actually made up of quarks, primarily up and down quarks. We saw that electrons aren't made up of anything smaller, and that they are what we call leptons. Taken together, leptons and our friends quarks are what we call fermions, those things that make up matter. Then we introduced the particles that mediate forces. Those were called bosons. And lastly, we introduced the four fundamental forces. Remember, the four forces that exist in the universe are the gravitational force, the electromagnetic force, the strong nuclear force, and the weak nuclear force. Hey, hey.